So as everybody's aware at this point, on Monday afternoon, evening, whatever it was, Judge Juan Merchan. Thank you, by the way, to the person on social media who pointed out that I have been for many months now pronouncing that name wrong. My sincerest apologies. It is Judge Juan Merchan. Anyway, Monday, Judge Juan Merchan goes out and expands the gag order saying you cannot attack my family. You cannot attack Alvin Bragg's family. You can't attack the families of anybody in the courtroom. So he expanded the gag order. And since that happened, Donald Trump has now shared two attacks on Judge Merchan's family members on his Truth Social account. The first one happened Tuesday morning, right? Just a few hours after Merchan had put that expanded gag order in place, when Donald Trump shared a clip from Fox News that was still promoting the lies about the judge's daughter, claiming that she had put that post on social media of Trump behind bars. That was not her. She did not own that account anymore, hadn't for over a year. But Fox News host Brian Kilmeade was still pushing it, and Donald Trump shared it on social media after the expanded gag order. But as if that wasn't enough, a couple days later, Donald Trump gets back on Truth Social, shares an article from Laura Loomer, you know, that bastion of honesty on the right, in which Loomer claimed that the judge has a huge conflict of interest because his wife, get this, according to Loomer, actually worked at Letitia James's office for a while. Trump shared that article attacking the judge's wife about a day and a half after he shared an article attacking the judge's daughter, which happened the day after the expanded gag order. So even though Trump is legally prohibited from attacking the judge's family, he has now done it twice since the prohibition went into effect. And here's the stupid part about this Loomer article. Even if, because I don't know the authenticity of it, unfortunately, Laura Loomer, not exactly somebody that I trust. But here's the thing, even if what Loomer is saying is 100% true, that, oh my God, the judge's wife worked for Letitia James's office even before Letitia James worked there, that's not a conflict of interest. In fact, it wouldn't be that uncommon for a judge to be married to somebody also in the legal arena who works at a separate legal office that has nothing to do with the case at hand. So that's not even a conflict of interest. That's just somebody trying to gin up a lot of hatred towards the judge's wife. So the article is meaningless to begin with, but it was an attack on the judge's wife. So here we are, day and a half after the latest attack on the judge's family, and where's the motion to hold Trump in contempt? I haven't seen it, at least not as of this recording. But how is this man able to clearly violate the gag order not once but twice and nothing happens to him? Now, we still got some time. Perhaps Judge Merchan is waiting for the end of the day to say, hey, Trump, you violated my gag order. I'm going to hold you in contempt. Come on into the courtroom. You're going to go spend the weekend in the county lockup. We'll see you Monday. He could do that. But more importantly, he should do that. That is what should happen to Donald Trump. It's what would happen to me if I violated a court gag order. It would happen to you if you did. Trump's done it twice in 4 days. Where's the damn punishment is what I want to know. Because he will continue to push the bounds of it. He will continue to do this and get more intense with it if there is no punishment. You have grounds to punish him now. He did the thing you told him not to do, and he did it twice. So double up the punishment and get that happening now. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.